Okay, so let's kick things off with a little camping trip, shall we? And this segment is specifically for the first-time camper. So someone who is wary of sleeping on the hard ground, dealing with bugs, cooking over a campfire. Man, this sounds like me. Or basically someone like Shona. Now, I have seen a bit of your camping setup here, Shona, and if this is really what camping can look like, if this is really what it can be, I may be persuaded to try it out. Maybe.
Right? I agree. Now, listen, when I finally agreed after 27 years of my husband asking me to go camping with him, and I finally agreed and said, okay, babe, this is the year. We aren't flying, you know, on trips to Europe or wherever else this year. Let's go camping. Once I dug in and did all the research, because of course I've got to research it all, I was so surprised, and I'm not going to lie, Tracy, I'm kind of jazzed. Like, this is a pretty cool world that I've discovered. So let's go over some of the important things. First, let's cover the setup. We're going to go through all the big stuff. So this is an 8-person tent from Coleman. Now, 8-person tents seems like a really large tent. It is. But what it's important to know if you're a newbie like I am is how they gauge it by the number of people that fit in the tent. It's literally that many people fit in a tent. A 2-person tent fits 2 people, and that's it. So because this is an 8-person tent, I chose it even though it's the 2 of us because I wanted a sleeping area and I wanted a little extra space to be able to walk around and have some, you know, a little table of our things set up. And of course, Murphy needs to have a little comfortable setup for himself as well because there's no way we're leaving him at home. And how about this, Tracy? This tent even has a closet. Yes, you heard me right, a closet. Can you believe that?
Even when the camera went in the tent, looking at that setup with the 2 beds, it looks amazing in there. And can you stand up and walk around in there? Because you're very tall.
I am very tall. I am 6 feet tall. My husband's over 6 feet tall. And the center of that is it's like 7 feet. It's no problem to stand up in there. And I have to say, a closet sounds like a crazy thing. Like, why would Coleman go ahead and put a closet in a tent? But it actually makes sense if you had raincoats or to tuck away your hiking shoes so it doesn't clutter up the rest of your tent. I just think that was such a smart little addition that seems like a bit of a splurge, but there's some sense behind it. So now let's go over to what is called a screen tent. So this is optional for a lot of people, but it's something I definitely would recommend because it's the place where you can get away from the bugs, you can get away from the really hot sunshine at shelter, you can get rid of the light, get away from a light rain if it's happening. And so you can use this as your dining room if you want. I've set it up as our lounge. So this is the place that we'll sit and enjoy, you know, our afternoon or our pre-dinner kind of snacks and maybe a cocktail or two, but we'll get to that in a minute. So these screen tents are great, and they come in all different sizes, and I think they're useful other than camping as well because they'd be really great for family picnics or just general get-togethers. Like, they have a purpose outside of your life. Next is the kitchen. You know how important cooking is to me, Tracy. And because I'm a newbie, because I'm a newbie, campfire cooking is not for me. I needed to have a really good setup. And this whole thing collapses into a little briefcase size case. It's really, really amazing. And because I'm not into the campfire cooking, I've gone with a stove, which is so great how it just sits up on here. And again, this is also, all of this stuff is so super portable. You wouldn't believe how small all of this stuff packs up. And when it comes to, you know, your cooking tools and utensils, they've even got pot sets for camping. I know there's some camping people out there are like, of course they've got pot sets, but they're all these space-saving ones. They all collapse into each other and they share the same handle for your cooking. Like, I just think all this is so fantastic. So all the comforts of your home you can have here in the campsite. There's a place to hang a lantern on this little kitchen. So if you're doing early morning breakfast or later in the evening snacks, you can illuminate what you're doing so you're able to work properly.
I just can't believe you have a whole house on the campground. You got a kitchen, you have a sitting room, a living room. You've got a little drink station. I mean, does Uber Eats deliver to the campground? It's the only thing we're missing here.
Tracy, no, you cannot do that. You're supposed to be roughing it, enjoying the camping experience. But see, this is what I call comfort camping. Yes, there's glamping, which is like really over the top. And then there's like backpacking backcountry in the woods. There's zero chance that's happening here. But this is like the comfort, and it's all so cute. It was just so fun to like go and get all this stuff. But you know, we have to have a campfire, right? You need to enjoy that campfire in the evenings. Think about what you want to do. And this by Kuma Outdoor Gear, this little couch, it's a cuddle couch. It's a for two. And I was like, it just called my name. I'm going to sip tea. I'm going to roast my marshmallows, and I'm just going to cuddle up here with Greg and Murphy, and we're just going to have a good evening. So a lot of people bring air mattresses. That's an excellent option. But for our camping trip, I opted to go with cots. I like the idea of them being a little bit higher up off the ground. And these cots are absolutely amazing. They're from Coleman, and they are extra wide, and they are extra long. And those are great for people that are tall and need a little bit more space. They hold up to 600 pounds. So I like the idea of having lots of space, and there's even some room for Murphy to cuddle in there if he's interested. The sleeping bags also are so important. Your sleeping bag is everything. You want to make sure you're buying one for the right temperature rating and the right comfort of when you're going camping, whether it be in the fall or the summer, the spring, or there are people who camp in the winter. So you want to make sure that the temperature is right. But these sleeping bags, just like the cots, are extra long and extra wide. And I was just like, yes, please. I had to go for that. So we went with two of them. But did you know a lot of the sleeping bags, particularly Coleman, you can zip two sleeping bags together to make one big one. So in the tent here, we also tucked in one of these foldable tables into the corner. It's good to have things, again, up on that little bit higher if you have room in the tent. What I've done here is I've just put a place for our wash-up area, and I've also put a place for a mirror. Now, you might be thinking, why do you need a mirror camping? No, I'm not going to be doing my hair, and I'm not going to be putting makeup on. I'm camping. But mirrors are good to have, just to have on hand in case. Like, just think if you ever got a bite or one of you got injured or something, you might need a mirror to actually be able to see it. So it sounds like a frivolous thing, but it's not. And you can get really great travel options that fold up. I got that one from Amazon. So just something, a little extra thing to think about. Another thing I also got from Amazon were solar power packs for our cell phones. So it's not because we're going to be staring at our screens the whole time. No, 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 no. But I like the idea of being able to have my phone fully charged in case of emergency or in case someone wants to get a hold of us and we don't have any electricity. So these solar work absolutely perfectly. Murphy has his own little station, of course, as well in here with his bed and his food bowls. But you know what I found, which I think is amazing? PetSmart has come out with a line called Arcadia Trail, and it's all geared towards outdoors with animals. So travel bowls, this is a glow-in-the-dark collar. I love being able to find him. A life jacket. It's all those outdoorsy things you need to take care of your dogs. I mean, of course, leave it to PetSmart to do something like that. Okay, so let's make it over to the screen tent. Ooh, do you like these? They're solar.
They're so cute, and I just like the color of them, too. It looks like decor. That's lovely.
So, as I mentioned, this is our like lounging kind of tent. This is where we're going to sit in the evenings or late afternoons out of the sun. So, obviously, it makes sense that this is where the bar is. I have discovered the smartest thing. So, Hydro Flask is like a thermos and water bottle cooler company. They have created a water bottle that is exactly the size of a wine bottle. Isn't that brilliant? So you can put your wines in here, your rosé or your white wines, and keep them cold, because it's all about keeping the beverages cold. They've also got a really massive 128-ounce bottle. And to give you an idea, that this will fill about 8 of these glasses, so it holds a whole lot. Lanterns are also really important. This one's cool by Coleman, and all of these pop off and become individual lights and flashlights for emergency. So there's so many of these cool things, you know, that you can have on hand. So now back to the kitchen, you know, one of my favorite places. Tracy, you're going to love this, because like you said, we are so the same. How about camping with a coffee maker? Huh?
Oh, yes. I am on this camping trip with you. Yes.
You're welcome. A 10-cup coffee maker. It works on top of your stove, so there's no electricity needed. Isn't that absolutely amazing? Of course, it's made by Coleman. It's drip just like at home. We can put on a pot of coffee first thing in the morning and enjoy it. Just because you're camping doesn't mean, you know, we don't want any part of paper plates. We don't want any part of single-use plastics, that kind of a thing. all of the traditional, these are so retro to me, the enameled plates and dishes, reusable, so cute also. And then they have really great cutlery sets as well with all of your needs for here, and they fold up in a really great pouch. Like, all of those creature comforts that, again, that you want.
Everything you have shown, I am all about it, particularly the beds, the cots, my goodness, the drink station. Thanks, Shona. That was amazing.
My pleasure. And look, I know it seems like a lot, but it all packs up so small. It fits in the back of our SUV. I tried it out without even struggling. So it looks like a lot and a lot of big stuff, but they are so clever about how they pack it up into all the different cases. You'll all be fine.